Hey there, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Yooka-Laylee. Well, actually, I got a patch, and I'm seeing if it's working. It should be a controller. It's a controller patch. I loaded up my game, and I started here in Hivory Towers instead of inside, Tribalstack Tropics, and yeah, this Pagie's talking to me. I was just going to run around and test to see if this was working, but since this is happening, I decided to turn on the recorder. Well, yeah, I already knew that. Yeah, so basically, this game has 5 worlds total, but each world is not fully explorable right off the bat. And throughout the game, you can use Pagies to expand them. And it basically adds, like, entire new areas and regions and stuff to the worlds. Also, it seems like there's 1,010 quills total in this game, and I know there's 200 per world, so that means there has to be 10 here in Hivory Towers. And how many? I found 8. So before I go into Tribalstack Tropics, I should go find those other 2 quills. I guess there's not a whole lot to actually find here in Hivory Towers. I'm gonna assume we have to stand on that button. By the way, I'd like to note that my controller is working with this dialogue. Well, of course, we're gonna have to expand everything if we want to 100% the game. Let's see. Yes, it works! Yes, this patch works! Yay, I am playing Yooka-Laylee with my controller. Let me see if I... Okay, left triggers... Oh, right. Oh, well, it's... Okay, it's exactly like the... Right. It's exactly like the Toy Box Plus demo now on the controller. Sweet! Great. Oh, man, this is so much better, because this game does not do well on keyboard. I'm so glad this patch exists. Actually, hold on, I need to check. Wait, who made this patch? Ah, yes, the maker of this patch is Iido, I believe? But yes, really, really, really appreciate this. This game feels so much better to play now. Literally, the only complaints I've had so far were mostly control-based, so... Oh, now that I can use a controller, that's all fixed. Anyway, the reason I'm coming back out here is because I wanna look around for those other 2 quills I missed. They're probably back at the very start. Nope. Whee! Oh, that wasn't smart. That wasn't smart. Ow. Get out of the toxic mess. I don't think there's anything here, is there? That's just a shortcut. Yeah, I do wonder where that rock is I need to smash. They said it was near a tree. They said it was a lone rock. Oh, maybe this one. Can I attack that, actually? No. Okay, I guess I will have to, probably smash that later. See if I can roll up this now. Oh, cool, I can. Oh. I thought that was like a bucket character or something for a second. Also, I cannot move the camera here. I guess this game does have... Oh, a Pagie! Okay. Oh, yeah, actually, let's check our totals. Yeah, so, I thought there was 150. There's actually 145 Pagies total in the game. Looks like Hivory Towers has 20. Tribalstack Tropics has 25. You know, I had heard that the levels had 30 pages in them, but apparently they have 25 total. So yeah, 5 levels would be 125 pages, and then there's 20 more in Hivory Towers. So I guess there's actually a whole lot of stuff to find in Hivory Towers. Just like Gruntilda's lair. So that's good. I'm glad to know the hub world actually is going to have a whole lot of stuff to do in it. But yeah, I figure that the remaining quills have to be out here somewhere. Oh, by the way, I completely forgot to show something off up here before. Y'all know classic rare humor. Also, oh, there's one of the quills. Check out what's written on the ship up here. Bat ship crazy. I actually saw that, I think, in, oh, hello. Alright, that's... Oh, it's got Laylee's face painted on it. I actually saw that in a video that was discussing the game a few days ago. I was gonna show that off, but I completely forgot. Anyway, I guess that's everything here that we can do right now. Because I know that's all the quills here, because I know that there's like 1,010 total. And the other 200 are obviously in each of the 5 worlds, so yeah, that'd make 1,000. You know, basic math. Oh, it feels so good to use a controller, seriously. This is the way the game was meant to be played. You know what? Look around here too thoroughly before. Let's see if we can find anything down here. Ooh, hello. Oh. Okay, that's nothing then. And capital B randomly chimes in to say stuff, just like Gruntilda. Boy, they really did go out of their way to make this as much like Banjo-Kazooie as they possibly could without using Banjo-Kazooie. And that's not a bad thing at all. Okay. I see a switch behind that, so we'll probably come through there later to open that. That'll be a shortcut, most likely. Hey. Yeah, I know I can't free him yet. I wish I could. I do wonder what this is up here. I reckon that there'll be some way to destroy or break that later. Definitely nothing I can do right now, though. Well, you know, I think that's everything we can do here right now, so might as well just go ahead and do this. Get in here. Okay, now let's actually explore Tribalstack Tropics. And I'm sure there will be much exploration to be done. Huh. Well, you were pretty easy to find. Oh! Did I lose health from that? Huh. Anything else down here that, I missed? No, I think that was it. You know, I do wonder how big these worlds are by default, though. It might be best to, like, explore them as much as I possibly can and get everything that I can before expanding them. You know, I'm happy that even on the lowest settings, I mean, even though the shadows aren't that great, I think this game still looks pretty beautiful. I mean, this is probably the lushest, most vibrant world I've seen in, like, in a game, and I don't even know how long. You know, I actually wonder how many times a world can be expanded, too. I'm thinking maybe, I don't know, maybe they can expand it, like, 4 individual times? I don't know. I'm just making assumptions here. Also, that is just like the one in the toy box demo. Like, you have to use like the same tactics to get it. Oh, whoa! I almost did something really dumb right there. That was kind of on account of the camera. The camera does have a few jerky issues now and then, but it's manageable. I keep wanting to high jump, but I don't have that. It just feels weird, like, playing the toy box demo with all these different abilities, and then all of a sudden you don't have any of them in the main game. Hey, maybe that'll be the first thing Trouser will teach us in here, though. I know we need to be finding him somewhere. Hey! Okay. You're just gonna keep sleeping then, I guess. Can't do that yet. You know, I've been thinking maybe each time you come to a world, you can find maybe 40 quills and 5 pages. Because then, like, one expansion would then give you access to a total of 80 and 10, and then another would be, like, 120, 15, and so on and so forth, until, like, the fourth expansion. Because I don't count, like, the first time to a world as an expansion itself. So, like, after expanding it 4 times, you'd have access to everything. I don't know if that's how it would work. I kind of doubt it, because we're already approaching 40 quills here. Oh. Ah, forget it. Just run through them. Is that ever gonna turn off? Oh. I didn't realize that quill was over on the other side of it. I thought it was in the middle of the fire. You know, something I have been wondering this whole time is if those images that we can see in the backgrounds of these levels are actually areas that will get included once it's been expanded. I really like that, by the way, that background scenery. That's just beautiful. Okay, well, we can't get up there until we get high jump. You know, that has to be what Trouser teaches here. Well, this place really is very open. Okay, then. Actually, I believe the transformation of the first world is a plant, so if you turn into a plant and talk to him or her, or whatever that was, then maybe you'd be able to talk to them and do something then. I guess in that sense, it's a lot like the Stonies from, the Mayhem Temple. Yeah! Okay, I'm guessing you're hungry, but I have no idea how to feed you. Yeah, it sure seems like it. Well, anything I can do to help? Probably. Wait, so do I have to like... Oh, yes. You know, I'm really glad that I can use a controller now, because I have heard that there is no, like, for the keyboard controls, apparently there is no key binded to what would essentially be the B button on the N64 controller. Meaning you cannot select no. Like you literally cannot say no to any of the choices. So, like, I don't know, I heard that pressing escape and, like, opening and closing the menu would apparently fix that, or it would allow you to, like, basically say no to a yes-no choice, but that's a pretty huge, like, oversight on Platonic's part. Well, that was pretty easy. Seriously, it's like every complaint about this game so far was basically just related to the keyboard controls. There's some issues there, but at least the game works perfectly with a controller. And to be fair, they do say that a controller is highly recommended. Wonder, can I go into all those, maybe? Also, I believe the game auto-saves whenever you enter or exit a world, so I might want to do that occasionally after getting a few pages. Or just generally just accomplishing stuff in a level. What? Where are we now? Oh. Okay, where does this one go? Let me guess, it takes me out over on the right side, probably. Oh, well, who'd have thunk it? Alright, those doorways are completely useless. Also, yeah, this here seems like it's just a dead-end path, but I will bet you that when the world is expanded, there will be something there. That probably leads to a world expansion. Nimble. Okay, because he's a Nimbus. Nimbus Cloud. Oh, so that's what you meant. I totally couldn't have guessed that because of the helmet. Yeah, sure, I guess. This game's got some good jokes so far. And the rings you jump through, these are literally just like in Banjo-Kazooie. Except they have googly eyes. Well, this is really easy. Oh! Okay, I shouldn't have slowed... Oh. Okay, how am I supposed to beat this guy? Oh, wait, right! You can... Yeah, wait, don't one of the butterfly types, like, increase your, don't they, like, refill your, energy? Okay, there's definitely way more than 40 quills we can pick up on our first try through here. Okay, I just lost that race hard. Yeah, sure, let's race you again. And I have no idea what Laylee just said. I wasn't expecting there to be more dialogue there, so I was just hitting A. Yeah, hold on, let's collect these, I think. No, they don't seem to instantly refill your stamina, although it does fill back up pretty soon. Okay. Let's see if we can catch up with Nimbus here. Oh, you have to collect them while rolling. Okay. Well, that explains it. I think I've lost this. I think you pretty much have to keep rolling non-stop or else you're not really gonna beat this guy. Actually, no, I might. Ah, okay. Oh yeah, we're doing this again right now. We're gonna win this time. do this. Oh yeah, this is gonna be easy as cake. Ooh, that was close. Yep, we got this race in the bag. Well, darn. I might have just goofed up, all because I missed that one. No, come on! Refill, 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 refill! Go! Yes, I won! That was awesome. Personally, I can't believe it either. Already? I guess we'll be able to race again after the world's been expanded. Alright, well, I think that is probably good enough for this episode, so let's go on and head out here to save our game. And that does it for this episode. So, see y'all next time, and we're going to continue exploring Tribalstack Tropics. Actually, I don't think I'm going to expand it yet. I want to just explore what's there right now. Anyway, see you, everyone.